In this movie, we're going to look at making asymmetrical distortion with trash. So I have just the trash module turned on here, and I have a drum beat. Sounds like this. And right now, I have symmetrical distortion where when I change the wave shaper here for the positive quadrant, these are the positive input values mapping to output values that are also positive. I have the same mapping here for negative values of the input signal mapping to negative values at the output. And the curve in this quadrant is the same as the curve is in this quadrant. That's symmetrical distortion. But if I put this in bipolar mode, now I have the ability to have one wave-shaping curve for positive values at the input and a different wave-shaping curve for negative values at the input. So, for example, I could create something like this just for positive values and negative values, still have a unity gain function here. Or I could have a very different kind of wave-shaping curve for the negative values at the input. I could even do things like swap polarities. So here, for example, many of the negative values at the input will map to positive values at the output. So this is a very different kind of distortion just for negative values at the input compared to the positive values at the input. This is the idea with asymmetrical distortion. Anytime I have the positive values of the input signal getting mapped one way to the output and the negative values of the input signal getting mapped in a different way, that's asymmetrical distortion. Now I'm going to clear it all, and I could even have something radical like this, where now all of the positive values get mapped to a unity gain function of positive values at the output, but all of the negative values get mapped to a unity gain function but inverted in polarity because they're mapping to positive values at the output. Which is, again, a very different kind of sound because I don't have negative values at the output anymore. So I've got lots and lots of different things I can do with this. Anytime I have anything different in the negative quadrant compared to the positive quadrant, I have asymmetrical distortion, and I can create some really kind of nasty and radical distortion this way. Or I can create just gentle differences between positive and negative amplitudes at the input and have a different kind of color to my distortion. Now, always remember that if you have a lot of nasty distortion, you can always go to the filter here, which is after the wave shaper, and you can filter your distortion. So you could take off some top end here, and with these handles, you can change the shape of the filter. And you can take off some low frequencies here as well. So this sound. Can be a bit more contained. And then of course mix it with the original. And you've got lots of possibilities to explore. So that's asymmetrical, what they call bipolar wave shaping, where you have a different function for positive versus negative values of the input signal.